London for the Olympics of 2012. Michael Phelps in the first of the finals, but he'll go from lane 8. It's 4 finals tonight, and here they are with their semi-finals to match them up. So the men's 400 individual medley, the men's 400 freestyle, the women's 400 individual medley, and the women's 4x100, the finals. And the semis are in the women's 100 butterfly and the men's 100 breaststroke. A jam-packed night. Some of the greatest names in swimming here tonight, including the biggest ever. And he's got a job to do because he's drawn the outside lane, Michael Phelps. So huge support here, Nicole, for the Brits tonight. And they've got some chances too with Hannah Miley.
They do. They do have some chances. The girls are through to the final of the relay as well from Great Britain. So the one thing that we've noticed already here in London 2012, and we have been here for a few days in preparation, is that everybody is, they're friendly. They're having the time of their lives here in Great Britain. They're very welcoming.
Saw some fast swims today. I feel like world records could be challenged in some events. Not sure about the medley because Phelps's time there is a remarkable one. At the cool zone, the warm-up area.
Into the inner sanctum here, you get to see exactly what goes on for the call zone. This is the women's 100 fly competitors. They're in the second event. So there is a final call room, and that is these boys moving through now. Michael Phelps, Ryan Lochte. Very different preparations. Ryan Lochte's a fairly calm, cool character. Michael likes to be in his own zone. Hood on, music going. I think he got a fright this morning, qualifying into lane number 8.
Well, it was a cat and mouse swim by him. He established a lead early, went fast through the first 100 and pretty fast through the first 200, but then switched off, but then really played with his nerves and all of ours, I think, and just qualifying. So he's in that final, and he hasn't lost an event at the Olympics since Athens, so he's got such a pedigree, and it's a great field.
And Chase's history tonight as well, with no male swimmer in the history of the Olympic Games having won 3 consecutive events, the same event on 3 consecutive occasions. 2 women have done it, with Dawn Fraser in the 100 freestyle and Christina Egizegi from Hungary in the 200 backstroke.
It's interesting too with the 400 IM, because Tom Dolan and Thomas Danye before him both won 2.
Yes.
So in the last 6 Olympics have been won by 3 men.
It's a very tough event. It's one of the toughest on the male program.
So big support for Phelps and Lochte. So for the American audience, they've got not one but 2 great swimmers. And I think Lochte's a great champion. His world championship record's remarkable, and his Olympic record with 3 gold is building.
Their rivalry in America at the Olympic trials helped with record crowds going along to the US trials, record crowds on television. And they're even having 1,000 people a day turning up to watch the US team train.
Lane 4 goes to this emerging Japanese swimmer, Kosuke Hagino, who today set a national record for the second time this year. So a couple from Japan and a couple from the United States, an Australian, a South African, a Brazilian and an Italian in the final of the 400 IM is the Phelps record. It's hard to imagine that being challenged here. The fastest in the textile suit is 4.622, so maybe that's the mark that's more reasonable, I think, do you think?
And that was Michael Phelps in 2007 at the World Swimming Championships to win that title. So I think that probably is more realistic, given that the boys were around the 4.6, 4.7 mark at the US trials. I think that is a very realistic time.
So the challenge for the rest of the field is, can they get down?
But you know, the thing that will be interesting is that they are not close to each other in terms of lane positioning, and they haven't had that happen before, Michael Phelps and Ryan Lochte. They're a long way away from each other.
It's a good point. So Harahata comes out. He's 3rd in the World Championships last year. He's the Asian champion from 2010.
Interestingly, finished 2nd at the trials in Japan, and both of the Japanese boys have made the final.
Well, their trials looked strong on paper, didn't they? So it's a good story for Australia and Thomas Fraser Holmes. He broke the record, the Australian record at the trials.
Yes, it was a long-standing record held by Justin Norris, and this is his first Olympic team. He's been on the Australian team since 2009. Trains in Canberra at the AIS. No, he is actually relocated to the Gold Coast and trains with Sun Yang, with Dennis Cottrell.
Interesting there with Lochte, just the T-shirt. And look, he's the world champion from 09 and 2011. So he's won the 2 big titles since the Olympics in Beijing.
A lot of athletes like to stay warm before they start.
Well, this is interesting, Hagenau. I mean, his national record in the heat today at 4.10.01, national record at the trials, emerging. Just can he get down to that 4.7.48?
He's made a big improvement in a fast time, 4 second personal best time at the Japanese trials. He won the World Junior Championships just last year.
Chad Leclos was one of the surprise packets today, but he is the Commonwealth champion from 2010.
Didn't make the final at the World Championships in this event, last World Championships in 2011.
Piera was a finalist in Beijing behind Phelps 4 years ago, so he's got a very good pedigree.
Strong backstroker. Finalist at the Olympic Games in 2008 was Pereira.
So with the moustache, Luca Marin, he was the minor medalist at the 05 and 07 World Championships and fifth in Beijing. Now here's a big cheer coming up. Well, there's never been a swimmer like him. It's 14 gold and 2 bronze for 16, his mum.
Debbie.
So there's a whole lot staring him in the face here. Just wonder what happened between the heat and this final for his camp. I mean, did they have any concerns? He's in a lane that rarely wins. We know that Kieran Perkins famously won the 1500 in Atlanta from this lane, but this is unusual, isn't it?
It is, but, you know, swimmers are taught that a lane's a lane. It's a space of water. It doesn't matter. It's just a number.
Well, we've never seen him rattled, have we?
I reckon he'll fly from the gun.
So the first of the finals and one of the really important races in swimming, I think. Historically, this great champion in lane 8. And there is the lineup. So the way in the final of the men's 400 IM, and Phelps is in lane number 8. So Harahata in 1, Fraser Holmes 2, Lochte 3, Hagenau 4, Leclos 5, Pereira 6, Marin in 7, and Phelps closest to us in lane 8.
Well, not a lot in it. Michael Phelps is taking it out, as I thought, and across on the other side in lane number 3, Ryan Lochte very strong. Leclos also putting in a good first 50 metres. It's a long race, so making sure that you're pacing correctly and not being thrown off by anybody else's pace.
So Leclos turns just in front of Lochte and Phelps. There wasn't much in it. It was just 0.1 of a second between the top three. And I think they've established a little break of about a half a body length over Marin and Pereira. So how does Phelps go in this first 100? He was very quick today, but he's not in front here. It looks like it might be Lochte in front.
Well, given his form over a 200 metres butterfly, Michael Phelps should be leading in the butterfly. He's very close to touching first here. These boys were neck and neck at the trials. It'll be the same here.
So it's Lochte by 3/10 over Phelps, and Leclos still in third place. So Fraser Holmes was fourth. So the challenge here now, the backstroke. We know how strong Lochte is in the backstroke.
He's a two-time Olympic champion in the 200 metres backstroke. There he is. The head stays very still, quite high stroking at the moment. So he is really trying to race this race, almost like a sprint. And at the moment, he's put in a big margin. But Phelps should come back quite well in the breaststroke and freestyle.
Let's see the margin here for Lochte. It's big, and they're on a very fast time here, a really quick time. Lochte's actually put over a second on Phelps. This is a dangerous stage for Phelps. Now, he has no contact with him because he's in lane 8 and Lochte's in lane 3, and there's a big margin between them.
And sometimes that's the motivation. You use that someone right beside you racing fast as the motivation to find something more. Right now, Ryan Lochte, a beautiful technique, rotating from hip to hip, side to side. Really good backstroke leg. I'll bring you up to date with the split once he touches.
So it's 0.37 outside the world record. Phelps is in trouble here. Hagenau's gone past him. He's into second. So Phelps, who's going for a third gold medal in this event, has so much to do. And Lochte has put such a margin between himself and Hagenau. And Phelps is struggling with Hagenau at the moment. And also with Pereira. Michael's in a lot of trouble here in lane 8.
Ryan Lochte had a faster split in that backstroke by 3 seconds. That was incredible. But Ryan Lochte is just doing such a great job. Michael Phelps is in no man's land at the moment. I can't imagine that he's going to get in the medals. He has a great freestyle leg, though. Let's hope he can have something. But let's not take anything away from Ryan Lochte. He's under world record pace still.
Pereira's come through very strongly. So an amazing race so far. Lochte with such a big lead. He has spent a lot of petrol, but we know his pedigree. Can Phelps find something here? He's been such a remarkable swimmer. But this would be something that would be extraordinary here. Lochte right on that world record pace.
So the distance that he has between the rest of the field, he should be able to double as he goes from the slowest stroke of the medley, the breaststroke, to the fastest stroke, the freestyle. Watch for the big kicks off the wall.
So the world record being challenged here, and Lochte surely now is on his way to the gold medal. Pereira second, Hagenow third, and Phelps unbelievably is in fourth place. Can Lochte keep going and not only take the gold medal from Phelps, but take the world record as well?
I think he can. The world record is a very fast swim in the last 100 metres, but he is really motoring. You can see the big six-beat kick, and it looks as though he's not slowing down. Look, he's putting pace on the world record.
Pereira having just a great swim in second place at the moment. And Phelps still out of the medal. So Lochte turns. Now that world record is very close. Pereira turns in second place. Hagenow third.
He's picking up his pace, Bruce. Ryan Lochte is finding something more in the final, the 400 IM.
So the world record is 4:03.84. Michael Phelps's long-winning reign has come to an end, but the world record's going to elude Lochte. But in many ways, he gets a bigger prize. He's going to get the gold medal here, and his great rival at the moment is struggling to get the bronze. Lochte wins. The Phelps reign comes to an end. It was glorious whilst it lasted. It's tight for second. Pereira, Hagenow, and can you believe it? Phelps has finished fourth here. Leclerc is fifth, and then behind them, Horahata and Fraser Holmes and Marin. An astonishing performance, his fastest ever. He has five of the fastest 10 coming in, but nothing as quick as this.
His family celebrating in the crowd. They look stunned. Congratulations, Ryan Lochte. Absolute star in the 400 IM. What a wonderful performance. 4:05.18. We talked about that fastest time in the textile suit, so the non-shiny suit. That was 4:06.22. And so, he's gone faster than that.
So you could argue in some ways, Nicole, that this is the greatest medley ever swum.
Yes, yes, without the assistance of the suits. From start to finish, he led. His butterfly was beautiful. He paced it well. He didn't try to put too much into the field. He was with the field, 55 seconds for the butterfly. He is an Olympic champion in backstroke, so we knew he was going to be strong there. Beautiful technique. His coach, Greg Troy, from Florida. He's also the head coach of the US men's team. Congratulations to him. And a big glide at the end. Perhaps coach won't be happy about that from a technical point of view, but he is the Olympic champion. And Phelps, fourth.
Concedes so rarely. So
you wonder if it's a little chink in the armour that he, from a psychological point of view, whether he can recover for the rest of the competition.
Well, that's the challenge ahead. So Lochte, 4:05.18, second fastest ever. Pereira equals the Brazilian record with 4:08.86. Hagenow breaks the Japanese record for the third time in about five weeks, 4:08.94, and then Phelps, 4:09.28. But, well, the medley has a new king.
I think these Olympic Games might see a new king. He's got a lot of racing, Ryan Lochte. It's the first of it done. And it's one for one.
His fourth Olympic gold medal, but it's his biggest in so many ways to take on the all-time champion. And Phelps, for the first time, doesn't get a medal at the Olympics in the swim. He had 14 gold and 2 bronze in 16 events before that tonight. So a fourth place, so unusual. Remarkable. First of the semi-finals of the women's 100 metre butterfly. So we had the heats today, and they were impressive too. And now the first of the semis. Kato from one, Tao from Singapore two, Zhao of China, and then Liu of China, and then Sjostrom of Sweden, Halsell, Great Britain, Hirasemenia, Belarus, Savar of Canada, who's a late inclusion here. She was actually the 17th fastest qualifier, but Decker withdrew after qualifying for the semis, probably saving herself for the 4x1, I think.
Yes. Defending champions, the Dutch, so I'm sure she would like to see that defended. This was fast this morning. It set the first Olympic record. And that was thanks to Dana Volmer.
So here's Yuka Kato, national record holder.
I like these introductions, Bruce. This is the first time that they've done this in Olympic history. Normally everybody walks out together and they step forward.
No, it's a great idea. Well, this young woman was fifth in Beijing, a real surprise packet from Singapore. And she's backed it up with another very good performance in the heat here in London. So she'll be aiming for another final here. It'll be tough, though.
Didn't have a great world championships. Only finished 15th.
Zhaolu Zhang was third at the World Championships in this event in 2009, but she's the World 200 Butterfly Champion, so she'll be strong in the back half here.
She certainly will.
Here's Liu Yang. So Liu Yang, third at the World Championships last year in Shanghai in the 100 fly.
China has won this event in Olympic history. It was in 1992. They were particularly strong at those Olympic Games.
He's the world record holder and world champion from 3 years ago. Was fourth in Shanghai in 2011, Sarah Sostrom.
Only two women from Sweden have ever won a medal in this event. And interestingly, the 100 fly, well, they've never won a gold.
So Fran Housel, who probably better known as a freestyler, but very good in the butterfly as well. And here, following her out, is Alexandria Harrisomenia, who was actually a gold medalist in the 100 freestyle at the World Championships last year.
So two girls in there that are better known as freestylers. Savard is in lane number 8, the Canadian champion. I was going to say, with Fran Housel, she's never made it through to the semi-final level in the 100 fly. So this is a good performance for her.
And a good marker to put down for the freestyle coming up. Both strong in the 50 and the 100 there. So two from China. And there's the world record holder at 56.09. But not favourite for the gold medal here. I think the favourite is Dana Volmer. So about to go in the first of the semi-finals for the women in the 100 butterfly. There is the lineup from top to bottom. Kato down to Savar. So away they go. Kato, Tao, Zhao, Liu Yang, Sostrom out pretty quickly. Housel, Harrisomenia, and closest to us, Savard. So lane 4 maybe just in front at this stage.
Yeah, they were good underwater. Liu was fantastic underwater, travelling there with Sarah Sostrom in the blue costume. She's got a little bit of work to do, but she will come home quite nicely. She's a great 200 freestyler as well, so she will have endurance in the back part.
So close here for the first 50. Kato actually leads in lane 1 by 7 100s from the two Chinese, Liu and Zhao. So good turn here.
26.76 at the 50-metre mark, so they are quite quick. Watch for Sarah Sostrom to try and make a move. She's in the yellow cap there, but, gee, Liu is strong, isn't she?
She is strong and holds a narrow advantage. Sostrom almost up to her, though. It's going to be pretty close. Sostrom going up to Liu and maybe has just taken the lead, I think, the world record holder. Sostrom and Liu, they're going to touch it together pretty quick, and Sostrom gets here from Liu and Zhao, so trying to get a couple that have gotten to the first three there. But Sostrom, you would think, automatically will qualify now with a very, very strong back half.
57.27. So the progression for these semi-finals from 16 swimmers into 8 swimmers, unlike athletics, it's about time. It's not about placings in the semi-finals, so the top 8 times. So we need to watch that, because 57.27, compared to Dana Volmer this morning, who went 56.2, is actually a second slower. So whether or not there will be a lot of girls in this second semi-final that will block people like Liu, trying to see the other times, Zhao, 58.04.
So here are the results of that first semi-final. Sarah Sostrom, 57.27, a bit quicker than she did in the heat. She did 57.45 today. Then Liu Yang at 57.51. Zhao Liu Yang at 58.04. Tao, good swim again, 58.18. Kato went out so hard, didn't she? She led it halfway. Back to fifth, Harrisomenia behind her. So world record holder, still only 18 years of age. She's achieved so much. Great freestyler as well.
Yes, she is. Her technique looked very good in that 100 butterfly.
So on to the second. And this looks stronger, I think, on paper with Volmer, a standout. Coots in good form as well. Odison and Donahue. But let's see how fast they can go. Volmer today, well, she set the Olympic record in the heat. It was along with the American record. And you felt like she was within a touch or two of the world record.
Yes, very much so. It was just a better start, a better turn and a better finish, and she would have had the world record. She said she likes going hard in the mornings, Dana Volmer, just to see what her body's got.
So Martina Granström first out, fifth in the Europeans last year, qualified in 58.70.
Ellen Gandy trains in Melbourne in Australia. She trains with Rowan Taylor, who was responsible for Liesl Jones' gold medals in 2008 at the Olympic Games. Katie Hayward, the breaststroker from Great Britain, trains there as well.
So Jeanette Odison-Gray. Jeanette was actually with Harrisomenia, the gold medalist in the 100 freestyle at the World Championship. They tied that.
Don't see that very often.
Now here's Dana Volmer. I mean, She really looks the goods. She's the world champion. She's the fastest in the world this year, and she broke the American and Olympic records.
She went to the Olympics in 04 but missed the 08 team, and now making a return.
Here's Alicia Coutts. Now, had this big Commonwealth Games, and that's when she really broke through in 2010. Second at the world titles last year.
5 gold medals at the Commonwealth Games. She went to the Olympics in 08 and she was just simply a 200 IM-er. Now she swims freestyle, butterfly and the IM.
Claire Donahue. Now, she was the Pan American champion last year. So she's emerging.
Graduated last year from the Western Kentucky University.
And Ilaria Bianchi of Italy is in lane number 7, 58.42 in the heat. 58.12 is her personal best.
Probably one of the smallest in stature. She's 5'6" or 167 centimetres.
And Crystal Vorner was 5th at the Europeans this year in the final there. So probably an outsider. But Vollmer, the one you talked about her in Athens, I think she might have got a gold medal in the 4x200, Vollmer, then,
yes,
all those
did.
Years ago. So.
And that was in a world record time. She finished 6th in the 200 freestyle final at those Olympic Games. So the disappointment of missing a team has really made her a better athlete for 2012.
I think she's in such sparkling form. This world record of 56.09, if it doesn't go here, it might go in the final. On the blocks for the second semi-final in the women's 100 butterfly, and the favourites from lane 4. There's the lineup. So Vollmer from that centre lane. It's Granstrom, Gandy, Otterson, Vollmer, and then Coots alongside of her. Both of those women out pretty well. And then it's Donahue, Bianchi and Verna.
Otson had a wonderful start in lane number 3, travelling underwater there with Alicia Coutts closest to you. But already Dana Vollmer's raw speed of swimming has caught up to Otson, and she will go around with a big lead.
And let's see how quick she is. She's really quick. Now, this could be on for the world record, I reckon. Otterson second, Donahue third, and behind them is Coutts. Now, can she hold it here? Has about a three-quarter body length lead here, Vollmer.
And her technique is fantastic, sitting so high in the water. Her arms are not skimming on the water at all. And look at the power of that kick. This is a fantastic swim.
So the world record of 56.06. Let's see if she can do it here. She's right on the pace, isn't she? Good battle behind her. This is the semi-final, remember. Does she get the record? It may elude her. It's going to be a touch and a go. It just gets away from her, but it's quick again. So it's Vollmer. Otterson's amongst the top three here, and Coots seemed to come home pretty well. It was a very fast swim. She went out so hard there, Vollmer, and Coots gets through for second, and Otterson hangs on for third.
That was a wonderful swim. It was really only in the last 7 metres that the world record just beat her. Sometimes that comes down to just the timing of the touch. She shortened up a little bit in the final stages, which is a sign of fatigue. It's such a fluid stroke. See the arms enter and then the waist and the hips follow. She doesn't lift her head very high, just takes and breathes every second stroke. But when she breathes, the mouth stays very close to the surface of the water, very efficient. And this is where she just tightened up a little bit and did the big lunge and kick to the wall. Full stroke, and she would have got that world record. You saw how short she started to get. But she had great pacing, that's why she started to fatigue.
So two very fast swims for her today, and there's the result, Vollmer in 56.36. Alicia Coutts has come home strongly, 56.85. She'll be in the 4x100. Jeanette Otterson also in the same boat at 57.25. Claire Donahue, 57.42. Nellen Gandy at 57.66. So where are the qualifiers? Mainly from that second one?
Mainly from that second one. I think Bianchi's actually got through as well. We'll see it now.
So here are the qualifiers. Let's see. So Vollmer, Coutts, Otterson, all from that same heat. Sjostrom, who won the previous one. You're right, Bianchi. So Gandy gets through. That's a good result. Liu Yang gets through, and Donahue going up. So Vollmer definitely the favourite. Coutts the second fastest. Otterson the third fastest after the semi-finals of the women's 100 butterfly. So what a night we've had so far. Big night for the United States, but it could be a very big night for Asia right now, because the very best from Asia is about to go here. No Chinese man has ever won a gold medal at the Olympics, and only one Korean, male or female, has ever won a medal at the Olympics, and both those men are here. I'm talking about Park Tae-won, the gold medalist.
Well, he would be thanking his lucky stars as well for those that missed it. He was disqualified in the heats of the 400 freestyle for leaving early on the blocks. It is a no false start rule here. He protested immediately through his team management here at the pool. That protest was rejected and he remained disqualified. FINA, our governing body internationally, held a very special sitting of 22 FINA Bureau members. They reviewed it and they have allowed Park Taiwan to come into this race. So they have quashed the disqualification for leaving early. So interestingly, he was disqualified for the same thing in 2004.
So here is the lineup. Ryan Napoleon from Australia will go from lane one. He was second in the Commonwealth Games in 2010.
This is a great achievement for Ryan to make the final of the 400 metres freestyle. Trains with Michael Bowl along with seven other Australian Olympic swimmers.
So Gogo Kiss, he's very good at the 800 and 15. We don't have an 800 at the Olympics, but he was a bronze medalist in both those events at the World Championships.
His third Games, and this is his first time in the 400 free final.
He had a good swim this morning. He took his trial swim from 347.8 to 346.2.
Both the two American boys in this field train with the Florida Gators and Greg Troy, so they're training partners of Ryan Lochte, so they've just watched him win a gold medal.
So Sun Young here, he's the silver medalist from the World Championships, but he's one of three men only to have gone under 341, and maybe he's the man to do the world record tonight here.
Coached by Dennis Cottrell at the Miami Queensland Club on the Gold Coast is Sun Young.
Vanderkei's already got a couple of gold medals in the relays, both from Athens and from Beijing, and he was fourth in this final in Beijing 4 years ago. So Park Taiwan's the man who won in Beijing. He's the world champion. He was a silver medalist also in Beijing in the 200, so he's got all of Korea's medals in swimming.
Yes. Well, Chinese men are doing exceptionally well. They've really come through to join the Chinese women in terms of accomplishments, but yet to win a gold medal.
Well, he's the youngster, Hao Yung, on this final. Just 17 years of age. He's the only teenager out there. And if he's the youngster, he's followed out by the veteran.
David Carey from Great Britain. Improved from the 2008 Olympic Games to make a final. He was 15th in the 400 freestyle in 2008, so a big opportunity for him.
So it looks a battle, doesn't it, between China and Korea, and with the two Americans thrown in, do you think, for the minors?
Well, Peter Vanderkei, it's nice for him. He's in between Sun Yung and Park Taiwan, so that might drag him along very nicely. One thing I know is that Park Taiwan will be very careful on this start. Plenty of time to catch up any deficit on the start, though, over 400.
So the nerves will be jingling a bit for him. Can he defend the championship here? Ian Thorpe did that, of course, in Athens after winning in Sydney. Murray Rose did it a long time ago. In Rome after winning in Melbourne. Americans have had a great run in this, but they haven't won since 84. Can China win its first gold medal, male gold medal at the Olympics? So the 400 freestyle final, they're away from the top. Napoleon, Australia, Kiss Hungary, Dwyer, United States, Sun Young of China, Vanderkei, United States, Park Taiwan of Korea, Hao Yun of China, and Carey of Great Britain. So it looks like Park Taiwan may be just in front in lane six.
Even after the disqualification this morning, Park Taiwan had the fastest reaction time off the block, so he has not left anything wondering when it came to his start, and they are under world record already.
By a substantial amount, and he leads from Sun Young and from Hao Yun. So it's Asia 1-2-3 after the first 50 metres of the 400 freestyle final.
The 400 freestyle is a great event to really settle into your stroke and have some tactics. The 200 freestyle, there isn't much time, but the 400 there certainly is. The first 100, Park Taiwan has really got into a nice rhythm with his technique.
And again, it's really quick. Oh. Look at this here, 1 second inside the world record. That world record, 340.07, but only three men have got inside 341. That was Paul Biedermann, who broke Ian Thorpe's world record by 1/100th of a second. So Park Taiwan here, to his credit, the defending champion, has said to Sun Young, if you want to take the title off me, come and get it. I'm going to put it on the line here.
And that world record was with the suit, so the world records were affected mostly in the back half, final stages of a race. So beautiful technique by Park Taiwan, beautiful streamline underwater, just one butterfly kick. Expect to see Sun Yung come back. His 1500 world record time, he came home very nicely in the second half of that 1500, and he's been doing great work on the Gold Coast with Dennis Cottrell in terms of his pacing.
So at the moment it's Korea leading from China, then the United States and the United States. So the favourites are right up there. He'll be so strong, Sun Yung, at the end of this back half, but Park Tae-won's probably increased the lead slightly. He's out to 0.3 of a second, and again they're about 0.8 in front of the world record, so it's a blistering pace as we go past halfway.
Now he's breathing away at the moment from Sun Yung. No, he's had a look at him. So both boys now are looking at each other and really making sure that they're pacing off each other. I feel like Sun Yung has a little bit more momentum in this third 100 metres. This is the 100 metres you really need to make a move. And I know Dennis Cottrell, Sun Yung's coach, very well. He would have told him, go. At the 300 metre mark, go.
Well, he's closed the gap, hasn't he? It's just three 100s. The 17-year-old doing a great job in lane 7, Ha Yun, and Van der Kuy pushing through hard also of the United States. The move has been made, and the best from China has taken the lead from the best from Korea, so the defending champion now being challenged by Sun Yung.
Park Tae-won changing the side that he breathes to make sure he does continue to breathe to Sun Yung. So he just had a little bit of a surge there, Park Tae-won, and he still takes the lead. And they're still under world record pace.
1/100th of a second between them after 300. One of the great finals in the 400 freestyle of all time. It looks like being the fastest ever, and look at this, they are literally stroke for stroke, though Sun Yung slightly in front now, in fact really putting the pressure on. I think Van der Kuy's got through for third place at the moment. This split, let's see how they turn. It looks like it's Sun Yung in front, still on world record pace.
Great swim, still on world record pace. You're right, he'll breathe away from Park Tae-won. No, he changes his stroke to see him. He wants to know where he is, and the big kick comes in now, big 6 feet kick.
So China going for its first gold medal from a male point of view. And could we see the first swim ever under 340? It's been a magical mark. That world record, he's right on it. Park Tae-won will be second. Van der Kuy third. Can he do the world record? It's going to be touch. And it's going to be yes, go. Not quite. 340.14.
7/100ths.
A magnificent swim. Park Tae-won, well, he went down fighting. China gets its first Olympic gold medal. From a male point of view, they've got seven with the women, but they've never had one before. And look at this guy. He's going to be one of the big stars in London 2012. What a reaction.
What a fantastic reaction. Well done, Sun Yung, Olympic champion, China's first in the swimming pool. What an amazing performance. Congratulations, China. And congratulations to Dennis Cottrell, his Australian coach based on the Gold Coast.
Well, Dennis Cottrell knows what it's like to have an Olympic champion under his wing, doesn't he?
With Grant Hackett, two gold medals, and now this is his third.
Tactically, didn't he do it well? I mean, he set off, when I say set off, the pace was so fast, but he made his move exactly when you said he would.
Yeah, the 300-metre mark was exactly when he was going to go. The technique is just beautiful. They're so relaxed with their hands and their grab of the water. Nice high elbows, not a lot of whitewash around them.
Well, only three men have broken 3:41. Paul Beedham and the world record holder Ian Thorpe and this man here.
That's fantastic to see that celebration.
20 years of age and from the most populous country in the world, and now the biggest star in swimming, certainly from a male point of view, they've ever had.
He's worked so hard for this. I've been hearing reports of his kind of sets that he's been doing at training and his work ethic. Anything Dennis asked him to do, he did it. He did it without question. And put 110%, if you can, 110% into it.
So China get a gold medal here. It's so close to the world record. Sun Yung, 340.14, an Olympic record. Park Tae-won, the gold medalist from 4 years ago, 342.06, great swim. And Peter Van der Kuy, who was fourth 4 years ago, gets third here in 344.69. It was China, Korea, and the USA after the men's 400-metre freestyle final. All men under 350, you'd expect that, but it was so sharp at the top end. So China got a silver medal in that event 4 years ago. That was the only medal they'd ever had from a male point of view at the Olympic Games. A silver, it was Zhang Lin behind Park Tae-won, and today, well, tonight, it's the same two countries quinelling, first and second in the reverse order. Didn't Park Tae-won go down screaming? It was a great swim.
He tried very hard. Well, all eyes start to focus on the 50-metre turn end of this beautiful complex, and that is where the presentation dais is located. There's the diving competition that you can see at the other end, the diving pool.
So our first presentation will be for the men's 400-metre individual medley. And I guess a minor surprise. He may have been favourite by the form students, but most people would have thought that Michael Phelps certainly would have got a medal, and that was the biggest surprise. Lochte's swim was quite remarkable. He was inside world record pace for such a long time. It's the fastest swim ever in a textile suit. So in many ways, you might argue that it's as good as we've ever seen.
But even from his time from US trials only 3 weeks ago, Michael Phelps would have got the silver medal there. So it is quite a surprise. It's hard to juggle that resting phase when you only have your selection trials a few weeks before, but the Americans have always done it that way.
And you do wonder where he will be now for the rest of the meet, because he's in six other events, cut one out, took out the 200 freestyle. That was the difference between Athens and here.
Maybe a loss is his kryptonite.
Well, he just didn't swim well enough tonight to suggest he's an overwhelming favourite. I mean, he couldn't beat Lochte in the 200 IM on tonight's swim, could
he? No.
And you wonder about the relays then.
But I mean, once he's had that loss, I wonder if he's mentally, whether he can recover.
Well, he fought back pretty well from Athens when he was beaten, but he was on the way up then, wasn't
he? Yes, he was.
It was a different time in his
career.
Holding
your form for four Olympic Games, although he was only 15 at the first in 2000, is a very difficult thing to do. Popov tried to do it and couldn't do it. Couldn't win the three titles, having competed at four Olympic Games.
No, it's an enormous challenge and a real surprise. A hurdle at the first, more than a hurdle, a huge obstacle, really. So Lochte now will be the centre of all attention, won't he? So we've had two remarkable swims here tonight from the male gold medalists. I mean, Lochte the best from the United States and Sun Yung the best from China. So two big swimming nations, two of the most powerful nations on earth, and both of them with a gold medal in pretty special circumstances tonight. And both of them challenging the world record and just coming up short, weren't they?
You get the feeling that there will be world records set at this competition, though. Oh. I know what the girls do in preparation for their medal ceremony. They're making sure that they look okay, combing their hair. I wonder what the boys do.
Well, maybe
boys do spend time on their hair these days, don't they?
Well, I think he's a bit of a favourite, Lochte, with a lot of
The thing about Lochte as well is that he always has something with a bit of pizzazz. He's got a pair of shoes that are normally gold with his name on it, and sometimes he puts a mouth guard in that flashes. So I wonder what he'll say for this Olympic ceremony.
He was the oldest man in the final. He's actually a little bit older than Phelps. So the introductions are about to take place. Out they come.
His ambitions after sport, Ryan Lochte, is to have his own clothing range. Dedicated himself. He likes fast food, likes junk food, but made sure he didn't have any of that in the last 2 years, getting ready for this moment.
Van de Ville of Peru, a member of the IOC, to present the medals. So the treasurer of the International Swimming Federation to present the flowers. A great swim, national record in both the heat and the final today. Aguna.
He's only 17 years of age at his first Olympic Games, and he wins bronze.
Well, he might be the future in this event. He'll be hard to hold out.
First time we get to see the flowers given in London 2012, and they're beautiful roses.
So 4 years ago, Brazil actually had a silver medal in Los Angeles in this event. Ricardo Prado got the silver medal, so they've matched it here a long time since then. He was right on exactly the same time as his national record.
He's 26 years of age, improving nicely from the last Olympic Games in 2008, where he finished eighth in the final. Now a silver medalist at the Olympic Games. Team USA's first gold medal of the pool goes to Ryan Lochte, one of three swimmers on the national team that has a very big program, along with Michael Phelps and Missy Franklin.
So for the fifth consecutive Olympics, a great American wins this event. Tom Dolan and Michael Phelps before him. Just a great race, it really was. I mean, Lochte set it up early. Pereira and Hagano both had good back ends, and the surprise was that they were able to best Michael Phelps for a minor medal, because Lochte really had, I think, the race won pretty early.
Yes. After that butterfly leg, when he swam to his strength in the backstroke, really no one was going to catch him from there.
You can see how marketable he'll be. I mean, he's the Johnny Weissmuller type, isn't he? From the old days, he became a big movie star after being a great swimmer in the 1920s and early 30s. And this guy's got charisma, hasn't he?
He does. Little bit of spunk as well, just in terms of having a bit of flair.
So the repercussions from this event are huge, aren't they? There's been a changing of the guard, maybe momentarily, but certainly a changing of the guard in the United States.
Although in discussing his events leading into the trials, the US trials, I mean, there was always a thought process that Phelps wouldn't race 400 IM, that in this stage of his career it was probably too hard of an event, too demanding. He has put the mouth guard in. Mm. I have seen him at a competition put one in that had flashing lights in. And this is a photo that will be with him for the rest of his life.
full of confidence. And for Brazil, not Pereira, not the biggest Brazilian name here, of course. No. Cielo is the favourite in the 50 and one of the favourites in the 100. Rafa Nadal started a lot of that, didn't he? Eating those trophies and eating those medals.
Yes.
And you feel with Hagano too that Japan's going to have a very successful Olympics. First day, I think, really sets the scene for how countries are going to go.
Yes, it certainly does. And we knew coming into this competition that the USA were leaders in the world rankings in quite a few events. So too Japan. I think they had four events individually that they were ranked number one in the world. Happy Team Lochte. The costumes of the medal attendees are beautiful as well.
It's such a classy arena, and everything that happened so far is in sync and rhythm with the aquatic centre. So Ryan Lochte with that exciting program in front of him. Off to the very best start possible. Just how does the Phelps camp respond here? And the American reaction will be fascinating to this result.
Well, he would be swimming down as we speak, Michael Phelps. There's a lot of work that goes on behind the scenes, warm-ups, swim downs, massage. So the boys, after enjoying this ceremony, will go off to the warm down pool, which is situated just behind the 50 meter end where the medals were just given out, and they'll do a lot of work. Someone like Ryan Lochte will do anywhere up to 1200 to 1500 meters of just lap after lap, trying to make sure the body has recovered and there's no fatigue left in it at all. They do blood testing out there to make sure that there is no lactic acid, which is the sign in the blood of fatigue. So they won't let him come out of the warm down pool until he's completely clear and recovered.
Fascinating, isn't it?
Sports science has come a long way in all sports. There's so much more that the athletes know and the coaches as well.
So now to the women's 400 individual medley final. Seen a remarkable swim in the men's. So the defending champion from lane one, so a little bit like that men's, wasn't it, where the defending champion was from lane eight.
She said in the quotes after this morning's race that she was a little bit sleepy in the first part of the race and had to give herself a talking to within the race to say, come on, Steph, pick it up, otherwise you're going to miss the final here.
So she's the world record holder and defending champion. Belmonte Garcia was fourth in the world titles last year. The Spanish women, they've got big numbers here.
She finished 14th at the last Olympic Games, so now she's firmly in the final.
So Hosu was the world champion from 2009 in Rome.
Great history in the 400 IM for Hungary, with Christina Egazegi winning that event in 1992.
Well, here's the favourite. Now, the United States has won four gold medals, but none since Janet Evans in this event in 1988.
She's a training partner of Ryan Lochte's. She admits that she gets a bit revved up before the start of a race, and Ryan says to her, chill, bees.
So Ye Shi Wan, who was fifth at the world title, just 16 years of age, so impressive today.
She was gold in the 200 IM at the World Championships.
So Li Jiangshu, she's the Asian record holder. She set that back in 2009.
That's an impressive time of 4:30 as well. This girl is a talent.
Great reaction for the Scot, the Brit, Hannah Marley, second at the world titles last year and sixth in the final in Beijing.
Trained by her dad, Patrick Marley. Always trained in a little 25 metre pool.
And Caitlin Leverance, with some support there from high quarters. So the second of the Americans, she was eighth at the World Championships, and she was second in the American Collegiate Championships behind Hosu, with Beisel actually third there. So Beisel, a narrow favourite here.
We have five of the top 10 performers of all time in the 400 IM in the history of swimming in this race.
So there's the defending champion and world record holder with the job in front of her now.
It's her nervous pre-race thing. She plays with her goggles, wipes her eyes.
Women's 400 metre individual medley final on the blocks and about to go. So Beisel, not so strong in the butterfly. She had a slow butterfly today. Let's see how she goes here. Rice from the top in that familiar Australian cap. And then Belmonte Garcia, Hosu, Beisel, Ye Shiwan, Li Zhangzhu, Miley and Leverance. That's the order from left to right, top to bottom now.
Stephanie Rice finished fifth at the World Championships last year in the 200 butterfly. So she should have a good butterfly leg in this 400 IM. You get the feeling as well that Hosu is making a move early.
So Leverance and Hosu actually turned together, Rice right with them. And Beisel, as she was this morning, a little bit off the pace in lane four. You can see how far back Beisel is at the moment, but she did that today.
Didn't she have a great breaststroke and freestyle leg? So no time to panic for her. She will swim to her strength. Hosu is a great backstroker as well, so she will really try to capitalise on the first part of this IM. She's in lane number three wearing a pinkish red colour costume.
So the first split comes up, and it's pretty quick. They're right on world record pace here, just inside. So Hosu, Rice having a bit of swim today. She had a pretty slow first 100 for her, but she's been able to take advantage of that good butterfly. Now, Hosu, good backstroker, we know that.
With this kind of company in a final of a 400 IM, Stephanie Rice can't afford to leave it to the second 200 metres of the 400 metres. So she needs to go fast here in the first part. Stephanie is also a great backstroker, and her breaststroke is quite good as well. So here comes Beisel as well, making a little bit of a move in the backstroke.
So Beisel was in eighth position after the butterfly, but she was actually quicker than she was this morning. The split today was quicker tonight in the final, so that's a good sign. Watch for her to keep coming. So it's Hosu, Rice making a good defence here in lane number one. Hosu in lane three, you can see them. Beisel has moved through really quickly in four. Ye Shiwan in lane number five.
Looking at the technique there, you'll notice with Hosu that the head doesn't move, but the body rotates. In fact, she's quite flat in terms of her rotation compared to right beside her with Beisel.
So Beisel moving almost alongside Hosu.
Look at this.
So it's Hosu, Beisel within 15-100s and in a good spot. Ye Shiwan not far behind. Rice back to fourth, but still maybe close enough, though the breaststroke will be difficult for her.
That was a 1:08 100 metres backstroke to Elizabeth Beisel. So a wonderful backstroke split. And look at the turn of speed in this breaststroke. She's really bobbing up and down quite quickly. Stephanie Rice is still there as well. Yellow cap at the top of the screen. And Hosu holding on.
And the two from China are making a move as well. Ye Shiwan and Li Zhangzhu. But it's Beisel leading. China starting to move up though.
Important to really use all of the turns. Long pull through, big butterfly kick. She looks. Beisel took a look.
It's her want, isn't it? So Rice still about fourth or fifth. She was fifth at that turn. So it's Beisel from Hosu, Ye Shiwan and Li Zhuang. Ye Shiwan starting to make a bit of a move here, the 16-year-old. Beisel's going to be hard to catch from here, though.
She made a big turn, though, Ye, into second place. So she's going to battle that out. Can she bridge the gap with Beisel? They had a fairly similar time this morning in the heats. Might come down to just an absolute fight to the wall. Momentum with Ye.
So into the freestyle leg. Let's see the gap. It's 0.8, 1.8 to Hosu. So Beisel leads Ye now to challenge and has moved up very strongly, almost alongside of her. There's a real fight on here.
No, she's got her. She's bridged that gap already. Look at Ye. The momentum's with her. She's going straight past Elizabeth Beisel. This is a fantastic swim by the 16-year-old world champion in the 200 IM.
Well, what a performance here. She's gone from fourth position about 100 metres ago and now putting a gap in Beisel. So the margin is almost a second. You would think it's impossible for Beisel to come back from here.
That was a 29-second 50 metres freestyle by Ye. So she's going to go a 59 in the 100 freestyle at the end of a 400. This is amazing, this swim. Let's watch this world record of 4:29.45.
She's right on it, isn't she? And finishing so strongly, Rice is going to lose the gold medal and the world record. She's well in front, takes the world record to another place again. What a remarkable back half. Breaks the world record and smashes it in the end. Beisel second and Lee third. So Ye Shi Wan, that was one of the most impressive performances in the last 200 metres you'll ever see. The back half of her swim there was quite remarkable.
That was incredible. She's gone 59.6 for the 100. 400 metres, individual medley, Olympic champion. And hasn't China had a wonderful night?
And they celebrate. So the youngest in the final, fastest by far. Beisel must have felt as if she had it at one stage, but so quickly did she go from second to first here.
And it was interesting, as soon as Yi passed Beisel, I saw her look under her arm just to scope to see where other people were. So immediately that's the psychological game. She'd gone past her and she started to sum up where second was and where third was.
And not only did she sprint away from Beisel, she actually sprinted away from the world record mark, didn't she? She went past it. So Beisel second.
I saw her do that in the 200 IM at World Championships. She was just so impressive. And that was last year, so she was only 15. She's a tiny girl. Very light, great power to weight ratio. Our first world record of the swimming competition at London 2012.
So Ye Shi Wan in a world record time of 4:28.43 over Elizabeth Beisel in 4:31.27 and Li Zhangzhu in 4:32.91. Stephanie Rice, the defending champion and now former world record holder, finished in equal sixth position with 4:35. So China 1, USA 2, China 3, Hosu Hungzhong for fourth. And then Miley 5th of Great Britain. Was a high quality final. But nobody could match this young woman. Her back half there was awesome. And I think it's now the realisation of what she's achieved is starting to sink in. But at 16, you're at a different stage, aren't you? I mean, it's
incredible. The defending champion, Steph Rice, giving her a hug, finishing equal sixth in the final.
Yeah, with 4:35, which was about what she swam today. Couldn't quite match what she did at the Olympic trials with 4:33. In Adelaide this year, but she wasn't the favourite after the heats, and probably coming in, it was Beisel and Ye Shi Wan. But Ye Shi Wan there, her second half of that race was insurmountable. I mean, it was breathtaking, to be honest.
Well, to be able to not only make up a gap of 0.81, but to go past someone like they were standing still, it's just phenomenal.
Beisel swam up to her very best form. I mean, she swam 4:31.27, which is faster than she did this morning. Faster than she did at the World Championships last year. So her swim was outstanding, but she was just blown away by this young, prodigious talent from China who's won the race by nearly 3 seconds in the end.
Well, if you're going to have the race of your life, this is a great time to do it.
Beisel's just missed the American record. But in the textile suits, it's the second fastest time ever by anybody, and that's what Beisel's done tonight. So I've seen
it's almost like suit era has no longer become a psychological block for anybody.
Yeah, but you feel like the time has come now that those records will go?
Yes.
There'll be some that will hang around. I mean, we've had that for years with the Janet Evans type record that were quite remarkable. There might be the odd one, but you think that they're going to tumble pretty quickly, and they're tumbling, they're starting to tumble now. If they're not tumbling, they're being challenged. And they were challenged in the men's 400 freestyle, weren't they, tonight? And we're about to have the ceremony for the medalists. So here are the medalists. What a great race it was. So the best from Asia, one and two, and the American third. But this man really celebrated, didn't he? Sun Yang.
So pleased for him.
Van Dibos of Peru, who is an International Olympic Committee member. We've met him already tonight. We'll be presenting the medals again. So FINA's vice president to present the flowers. What a great career Van der Kuy has got. I mean, an Olympic bronze medal tonight, twice a gold medalist in the 4x200, once at Athens and once in Beijing. So he goes from fourth 4 years ago in this event.
Very popular member of the team as well. It's a University of Florida graduate, and Greg Troy is his coach, who is the US men's coach.
So he was fourth behind the man who finished second tonight 4 years ago. So the bronze medal for Peter van der Kuy. So Park Taiwan here. So gold medalist 4 years ago. He was a silver medalist also in Beijing in the 200. So he has one gold and two silvers. We'll see more of him. He'll be in the 15 and probably the two as well.
Yes, he will. And after the disqualification, then reinstatement after the heats this morning, I'm sure deep down he is happy with the silver medal. He did put in a great performance as well, fought right to the end. You'd have to think that Sun Yung's where he was 4 years ago.
So the fastest time ever at the Olympics in the 400 free. He's the first Chinese male to win an Olympic gold medal in swimming. So he holds a special place now in Chinese Olympic history. So close to the world record, and he is the world record holder in the 1500 meters, and that record could go again.
Yes, given his form already.
Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of the People's Republic of China.
So there, the gold, silver and bronze medalists from the men's 400 meter freestyle. Chinese men, what a great role model he'll be. They've been emerging now for probably the last 8 years. Their women made such a splash in the early 1990s. Yes. In
yes,
Rome,
they
dominated the World Championships in 94.
They did.
And but their men were not so prominent, but they are now coming to the fore, aren't they? Particularly in distance freestyle swimming.
We've had some glimpses of some of the Chinese men having success before. So the challenge now is to have the longevity as well, like we've seen with the Phelps and the Park Taiwan. So He seems as though he has a smart swimming brain as well as good work ethic. You hope that when he trains as hard as he does for an event like the 400 and the 1500, that it doesn't get worn out.
And I guess for Australia, a little bit bittersweet. I mean, both these young men train in Australia.
Yes.
And guided by Australian coaches.
Yes.
And it's been a great event for Australia in the past,
yeah,
with Ian Thorpe and going back to Murray Rose and others, Grant Hackett,
Kieran
of
Perkins.
Course, Kieran Perkins. But both these men training.
It's ebbs and flows, isn't it?
Yep.
You know, Australia has never had a period of time of not having a distance freestyler for as long as I can remember.
So do you think they'll continue to go offshore, the Chinese, do you feel, in terms of coaching?
I think it's been very successful. Having said that, they do have some really good training venues throughout China, and I know that some of the Australian and other countries have been going to train at those venues in China. In fact, they have some really good high altitude training facilities that were built for the Olympic Games in 2008 all throughout China. So I know other countries have been utilising those.
And what a boost, Nicole, when you think that they had the World Championships in Shanghai last year, the Olympic Games in Beijing. I mean, all those great events help to promote the sport so well, don't they?
But they're also starting to lay a legacy. They're starting to lay history and heritage in the sport of swimming. So all young kids look up to people like Sun Yung, and they want to be like him.
Well, here's the first, I think, of the really big, big Chinese male stars in swimming. And tonight he's made his mark on the biggest stage of them all. So close to Biedermann's world record, so close to Thorpe's best time ever. So much in front of him, he's achieved so much already. But you'd love to have shares in a man like that, because you feel like for the next 4 years he's going to have so much success. I mean, he's interesting in the 200 free, because that'll be a great race. But Park Taiwan will be there, others will be there, Sun Yung will swim it, I'm sure now. So a big night for the United States as well, with the First Lady in attendance tonight.
It's been a big period of time for dignitaries across the world. Of course, the opening ceremony last night, which was so impressive.
Just thinking aloud, Nicole, Ryan Lochte in the 200 freestyle, is
yes, that was the one that Michael Phelps decided that he wouldn't race, so, and he chose the 400 IM instead.
So what a battle that's going to be.
Yeah, it's going to be an amazing, amazing race. You know, we haven't even seen the likes of Missy Franklin race yet. She'll race in the 4x100 freestyle relay. She will lead the American team off. She's got a big program of 7 events.
Men's 100 breaststroke semi-finals, so a couple of semi-finals. The first one highlights the great champion who now may become the first man to win the same event at 3 Olympics. I'm talking about Kosuke Kitajima, who won this event in Athens and also Beijing. He also won the 200 breaststroke. So with Michael Phelps' demise tonight,
yeah,
in the 400 individual medley, he may get first crack at achieving an historical performance.
It does open that door.
So the introduction. He's the world record holder. He was 5th in this event in Beijing and 5th at the World Championships in 2011 and the world champion in 2009.
Where he set that world record.
He's the comeback kid. Well, he's 30 years of age. He was 2nd way back in Athens behind Kitajima, so he knows him so well. He probably went into Athens as the favourite, I think, Hanson.
Yes. Cameron Vandenberg, expect him, Bruce, to be out very fast in the first 50.
He was a bronze medalist in this event at the last two World Championships, but he's very good at the 50, isn't he? Kitajima coming out now. Well, he's the all-time great breaststroke. I think that's fair to say.
Yes.
He's won the gold medal at the last two Olympics in both the 100 and the 200. He looks relaxed. Daniel Goerter, interesting, saw him emerge at Athens basically from nowhere, and he's gone right on with it. He's the world champion in this event in the 200 breaststroke. So here's Tatishi, the second of the Japanese. He's actually the record holder at 50.
He is really an emerging talent, isn't he? Having someone like Kitajima leading the way, sometimes it's hard to develop new champions.
Scazzoli here is the European champion and the silver medalist from the world titles last year. And Felipe Lima of Brazil, he was second in the Pan Americans last year in 2011. So many of the swimmers got under 60 seconds in
they
the
did.
Heat.
12 of them. Coming into the Olympic Games, Tatishi actually had the second fastest time of the year behind Kitajima.
So can he put down a mark here, Kitajima? He was happy after the heat, wasn't he?
Yes, he was. He trains in America now, so this has been a different Olympic preparation for him. But he got to sit down and watch the US trials in person.
Well, Vandenberg will give him a sider early because you feel like he'll lead in lane three, green cap. So watch for him early. And Kitajima maybe to come off him. The world record holders in lane one. First of the semi-finals in the men's 100-meter breaststroke. And the defending champions in lane four. So from the top, Rickard Hansen and Vandenberg, Kitajima, Goerter, Tatishi, Scazzoli and Lima. So he is out fast as we expected, Vandenberg. And also Scazzoli's out very quickly.
But off to a very good start too is Kitajima and Goerter from Hungary. So there's not a lot in it. And we saw Vandenberg fade very, very severely this morning in the heat. So I would expect that this is a fairly good first 50 metres for Kitajima because he has great second turn of speed.
So Vandenberg, Scazzoli and Rickard and fast there. Now Kitajima actually was in eighth position with something to do, but he's capable, but he's got a lot to do in lane four here. He's a fair way back. Vandenberg, Scazzoli in lane seven. Kitajima with so much to do. Rickard having a good swim in lane number one. I don't think Kitajima can get up there. Now, the qualification will be interesting. The world record's eluding Vandenberg for the moment. Scazzoli not far away. Katajima's in trouble here. This will be interesting to see if he qualifies. Vandenberg, Scazzoli, Rickard, Kitajima's got a problem, I think.
Well, he's qualified into fourth. And 59.69 is his time.
Well, we've got, look at that time, by the way. That's an Olympic record, 58.83.
Well, I watched him fatigue quite severely, Vandenberg, in the heat. So he found something more for the semi-final because he was out fast, 27.47. He was under world record pace by 0.2 of a second. Just missing the world record, but taking the Olympic record. And there was no fatigue and not any signs of fatigue. He stayed straight down the center of the lane. And whilst they swamped him this morning in the heats, he maintained his lead and the only swimmer to go under 59 seconds. A convincing win in the end.
Well, that was a stunning performance, as you say. He just kept on coming on, didn't he? And well, Kosuke Kitajima now has to wait and see whether that's fast enough. It was such a fast semi-final, you feel it might be. Scazzoli, great swim for him. Brendan Rickard back in some good form there. 59.5, the world record holder. Kitajima, 59.69. I mean, the time's pretty good, but the fourth position makes him vulnerable, doesn't it?
Well, considering that in the heats this morning, we had 12 men go 59 seconds. So that is a real concern for the double defending Olympic champion.
It's the fifth fastest time ever, by the way, for Vandenberg. Now, the second of the semi-finals to come up here. So, don't know if it'll be as fast. You wouldn't think it would be quite as quick as that first one. I mean, we've had an Olympic record. That's hard to beat at any stretch. So, let's wait and see. So, the second of the semi-finals out, they will know what times they need to achieve. But it was such a fast time that doesn't make it any easier. Now he's the world junior champion, Craig Benson, and he swam a personal best in his heat. He almost got under the minute. He was 60.04, so he's a big talent from Great Britain.
And they've lined up at the Olympic Games, hoping to race the best in the world, and he lines up next to his teammate, Michael Jamieson.
Who got under a minute today, so two great swims by the two Brits. Glenn Schneider's got to 59.78 today from New Zealand.
He's a really good talent, Glenn Schneider. Schneider has a good turn of speed in the first 50 metres, but he can also race 200, so he's got some endurance as well.
Here's Christian Spring. Now, he beat Brenton Rickard in the trials. I think it was 59.91 from memory in the trials. Now, he's just seen Rickard have a terrific swim in the first semi.
And they're fierce rivals back home in Australia. In fact, at national titles, sometimes they haven't been able to separate them. They've been dead-heated at nationals.
Gadiras Titenia, so from Lithuania, so 59.68. That was a national record in the heat.
He has medalled at world championships before.
Scott Dickens of Canada, he set a personal best in his heat, under a minute.
This is a story, isn't it?
Eric Chanteau.
Diagnosed with testicular cancer before the last Olympic Games and put off treatment so he could race. He's now been in remission since that time and continues to do some wonderful work throughout the world for cancer survivors.
And Felipe Silva of Brazil in lane number 8. So what an interesting mix we have here, the young and the old. But a mark has been put down by Vandenberg in the first of the semi-finals, an Olympic record of 58.83.
Here's Springer.
So, Titenis with that green cap alongside Springer. The two British swimmers in 1 and 2. They'll get great support. There's the lineup. It's the second of the semi-finals and the men's 100 breaststroke. So, Benson, the world junior champion from the top. Jamieson, his teammate next to him. Then Schneiders of New Zealand. Springer, the Australian, in 4. He's out well, Springer, and so's the man in lane 8, Silva. We expected that. He's fast in the first 50. So Schneiders and Springer, the two from down under, are showing some good form early. Let's have a look at the split coming up at 50.
Great underwater there with Scott Dickens as well. Not a lot of time to have a long glide at the end of the stroke in the 100 metres. Get into your work very quickly.
So it's Springer who turns in front of Schneiders and Titenis. So not much between the first three as you'd expect. Schneiders has come up on Springer. Titenis coming up on him as well. Can Chanto make a move?
And Silva is holding on over in lane number 8, which is surprising at this stage. Nothing in it. This is not good news for Katajima, how close this second semi-final is.
But I guess the question is how quick. Now Springer's slowly but surely just pulling away from Schneiders, but Titenis is coming at him. They touch it, and Springer gets home in front of Titenis, and Jamieson gets through for third. Now, just how quick are they? That's the point of view. I reckon Katajima might get through to the final now.
He's definitely in, Katajima. I think he's in 7th. We'll wait for the summary. But the winning time there, 59.61, Christian Springer.
Well, he's in good form, Nicole. He's backed up a really good heat swim, hasn't he?
Which is something that he's been working on. It was one of the concerns that he had. One brilliant swim out of the 3 appearances at major meets and not able to back up. So this is good news for Christian Springer. Felipe Silva held on for quite some time. He ended up in 5th.
Well, Schneiders is the one that fell away at the end. He got down to 7th place. Jamieson was the one that came through so strongly at the end.
Oh, look at this touch. Nothing in it at all. See, the boys were in an arrow position with the hands, and then the hands separate to touch the wall firmly with the palms of their hand, not the fingers.
So the winning margin, I think, is about 5/100ths of a second as we check the result of that second semi-final. 59.61, 59.66. So again, a national record for Titenis. Jamieson, 59.89. Chanteau at 59.96. That mightn't be enough. Jamieson, I think, might squeeze in. So the two semi-finals are down, and let's have a look. Jamieson might just have missed, but Katajima has made it. Hansen's made it. So from the top, Vandenberg, Scazzoli, Rickard, Springer, the two Australians together, Titenis, Katajima, Goethe, Hansen. So Jamieson does miss out.
And the dream stays alive for Kasuki Katajima, trying to win a third consecutive 100 breaststroke at Olympic competition. But he will have his work cut out because Vandenberg just looked fantastic.
Yeah, he's going to have to find something, isn't he? So always a highlight is the women's 4x100 freestyle. And this is a fascinating final.
Some cat and mouse has gone on since the heats this morning in terms of changing changing members of relay teams, particularly Australia and the USA.
Yes, Australia's changed most of theirs, and the Americans are not far behind them. And they've gone the same way with a couple of changes. Australia's changed three, though. So here come the Swedes.
That's the thing I love about relays. It's so much more relaxed in the marshalling area, the final call room. You've got your mates with you, and the girls just epitomising that by having a little dance on full deck.
So they've kept the same group, and so have the Japanese here. Yuida actually gave them a great start this morning, and she leads off again here. They were seventh at the World Championships last year.
Defending champions come out next, world record holders as well. They have made one change as well, haven't they?
Yep, they brought in the number one 100 metre swimmer for the year,
Kromo Wijojo.
And look, they've won the Olympics and the last two World Championships. They've had a big reign, haven't they? A big run here, the Dutch. They're going for four in a row, so to speak. And the Australians had their big run, didn't they, when they, in that 04, 05, 07 period. Have a look at that.
That was a bit awkward. Alicia went to keep going and remembered she had three girls behind her.
So coming in for Australia, Coots, Campbell and Schlanger.
And the youngest of the group in Brittany Elmsley survived from the morning. She was the fastest of the morning swimmers.
So out come the Americans. It's been a while since they've won at the global level. 2003, they've been so close so often. So Missy Franklin and Jessica Hardy, the two to come in here.
And we get our first glimpse of Missy Franklin, Melissa Franklin, better known as Missy, and Jessica Hardy, who is the national 100 freestyle champion.
So China, one change here. Peng comes in to swim the anchor, but they go with the same first three that put them through to the final. They were fourth in Beijing, twice silver medalists back in the 90s, China. So here are the Danes. They actually got a silver medal in London in 1948.
Oh, wow.
So it was a long time ago, isn't it, in this event.
And Otsen is their anchor woman. Of course, she was equal world champion in the 100 freestyle last year. What a wonderful spirit for a home crowd and a home team. Look at that.
Fantastic response. So Housel comes in. Smith swam well this morning. Well, their one gold medal in this event came in Stockholm in 1912, so 100 years ago.
So it's been
ago.
A little while between gold medals.
100 years.
Well, important to swim fast, but it's also important to be safe on the relay changeovers. You must have the pressure of at least one toe on the blocks when the swimmer that's coming in touches the wall.
So what a great race. That world record, I think, could be broken. They'll go close. Can the Dutch do it again? Can they win the Olympics as they did in Beijing and the World Championships in 09 and 11? So the final of the women's 4x100 on the blocks. There's the lineup. So the Swedes up the top. It's Coleman and then Yuida of Japan, Decker for the Dutch, Coots, Australia, Franklin, USA, Tang of China, Bloom, Denmark, and Smith of Great Britain.
Well, Missy Franklin has got off to a pretty good start, but really the centre lanes, China, USA, Australia, and the Netherlands, there's not much in it at all. If anything, it is the Netherlands through Inga Dekker that is getting off to the best of the starts.
We'll check that split after 50. Holland, China, USA, 1, 2, 3, Australia, 4.
Under world record split for the 4x1. It's off the records for the 4x1, not off the 100 freestyle individual.
So let's see who can touch the wall first. It is oh so close. China right there alongside USA and Australia and maybe China. Here's the touch. It's the United States, actually. So Franklin's done a great job there with a 53-52.
That was a great split. 53-9-0. Australia also under that 54-second mark. So too China. And the Dutch were right there as well. 54-67. So they started to fade off with Inga Dekker.
So USA, Australia, China. That looks to be the order.
So Jessica Hardy in the water for the USA, formerly a breaststroker, now a wonderful freestyler. The straight arm technique she's going with.
And Kate Campbell not far away, the Australian. So she's there. The Brits are having a good swim too in lane number eight. But it's USA and Australia.
A great leg by Kate Campbell, Olympic bronze medalist in the 50 freestyle. She's come back from injury and illness, and she's really taking it to the USA. Great Britain having an okay swim as well.
So we're halfway in the 4x100. USA are 4 100s in front. Great Britain is in the bronze medal position. Elmsley goes in for Australia. Newell goes in for the United States. Lloyd goes in for Great Britain. This is a great battle. Can the Dutch come back? They're in about fifth place at the moment. China not too far away. Things can change in a 4x1, but at the moment it's the old firm. It's the Aussies and the Americans.
Well, the newest member of the Australian team is Brittany Elmsley. She did a great job in the heat. She's racing against Leah Neal, who is a little bit more experienced than her. But I tell you, the young girl from Australia is not shy at all. She trains with Emily Seebohm, and she is racing this race.
The Dutch and the Chinese and the Brits are just behind Australia and the USA. If anything, it looks as if Australia's edging away. Now, Schlanger to go last against Schmidt. Australia will certainly turn in front on the last leg.
Oh, they've got to be safe on these changeovers. Nice changeover by Melanie Schlanger.
So 0.2 of a second. Now, the Dutch, the defending champions, have got Kromer with Jojo to go, so she's someone to watch in lane number three.
She's already taken a tiny bit of water off Melanie Schlanger. So Kromer with Jojo's in lane number three. Melanie Schlanger with the white cap in the centre. And then Alison Schmidt underwater there, closest to you with the black cap. Melanie Schlanger is flying. She has had an incredible 12 months. And she has just been waiting for this moment. It's going to come down to the wire. Here comes Kromer with Jojo.
Watch out for the Dutch. So Australia leads USA and Holland. What a great race. Schlanger, Schmidt will be strong at the end. Kromer with Jojo had to use a lot in the first 50. Schlanger holds a good lead though. Australia hanging on here, I think, from Holland and also the United States. Schlanger's in front. Kromer with Jojo can't quite get her, and the Australians will win the gold medal. It's Australia first and an Olympic record. They take the gold off the Dutch and the USA in third.
What a fantastic performance by the Australian girls. Mel Schlanger straight out of the water to celebrate.
Well, it was such an even performance by the Australians.
There was a slight
it?
Panic about Melanie getting out of the water, whether or not she was allowed to. None of the other girls had got out. Oh, what a fantastic performance. An Olympic Games gold medal to Australia. Opening night, 4x100 freestyle. Great Britain, they finished in fifth. Oh, that came down right to the wire, didn't it? Kromer with Jojo, what a great split by her. That gives you a glimpse of the 100 freestyle. Well, this is Brittany Elmsley, her first Australian senior team. And she gets to win a gold medal at her first appearance. She's just been a standout age group swimmer. Melanie Schlanger, well, she had a little bit of an up and down period a couple of years ago and decided that she would really dedicate herself not only to training, she trains with Glenn Baker on the Gold Coast, but also to eating, making sure that she was eating exactly what she needed to eat to give herself good power to weight ratio. And the hard work that all of these girls have done is just incredible. They've had relay camps to try and bond all throughout the year after the qualification. Brittany Elmsley saying, I can't believe it.
Dawn Fraser won this event in 1956. Australia's won the event in 56 and 2004. Here's the final result of the women's 4x100 freestyle. Australia in an Olympic record of 333.15. Netherlands, the defending champions, 333.79. The United States, 334.24. Then China, Great Britain, Denmark, Japan and Sweden were disqualified. So the strength at the top, the USA again, a minor medal. They haven't been able to win at the global level since 2003. They came close, but Australia, who won so famously actually in Athens in 2004 off the back of Jodie Henry, really.
For Kate Campbell there, the young lady with her cap off, I mean, the last 4 years has been incredibly rocky for her. She has had hip surgery. She got diagnosed with chronic fatigue. Then she had post-viral fatigue. So it's been a huge comeback for her to even be healthy, let alone swimming and winning an Olympic Games gold medal.
And what a good performance by the Australian selectors. They changed three women into the final. They kept Elmsley, who swam very well again, is Kieran Perkins, of course, the great 1500 metre gold medalist from 1992 and 1996, and was second in Sydney. And Dawn Fraser, who's the great 100 metre freestyler, who won the gold medal in 1956, 60 and 64, and won this event with Lorraine Crapp and others in 1956. So a great performance by the Australian team there. And Libby Trickett, who swam in the preliminary, will get another gold medal to her name. So that comeback for Libby Trickett has been oh so successful after tonight, hasn't it?
Yes, the heat swimmers do get the gold medal, so that has been a wonderfully successful comeback from Libby. I'm hoping she'll continue to swim past these Olympic Games. Emily Seebohm, another of the heat swimmers, and Yolaan Kukla, they will all be Olympic Games gold medalists as well.
So the Dutch looked to get a good start, but just at the end of that first 100, they fell away a little, didn't they?
Yeah, it was even off the first swim by Inga Dekker. She was out brilliantly, but then she just faded, and I think they were almost in eighth.
They dropped back. They'd certainly dropped back after it looked like they were challenging for the lead. So Dekker actually was in eighth position,
yeah.
54.67. So her last 25 metres, she withdrew, remember, from the butterfly tonight in the semi-finals. Not sure if everything was okay with her. Cromwell with Jojo put up a great performance. I thought Missy Franklin was impressive tonight, didn't you?
Absolutely. Again, gives you a bit of a glimpse. I just wanted to point out that Marlene Wildhuis, well done to her. She's a mum.
Yeah.
You know, she has a young toddler. And she's now an Olympic silver medalist as a mum.
They've been basically the four women that have been doing the great job, haven't they, for Holland. So a ceremony about to come up. And this was a remarkable performance in the women's 400 individual medley. A 16-year-old from China not only took the gold medal, but she took the world record in the process.
Doesn't she look happy? You think about what other 16-year-old girls are doing. And it's a remarkable achievement.
Yes, she won there.
What a great smile.
So Kuwaiti International Olympic Committee member to present the gold medals.
President of FINA joining him.
Asian record holder before tonight, but a great performance by her, the 18-year-old, to get a bronze here. That record going, of course, because of the world record that went, but strong swim. So China with a couple of the medals here.
So Lee adds to her one bronze medal from the World Championships with a bronze medal from the Olympics.
So they've got all colours now, China, because Lin Li won a silver medal in 1992 in this event behind Christina Ezazeki.
I do remember that.
Great swim, I think. She had a terrific swim in the heat and she backed it up in the final.
It was a gallant effort, wasn't it? She swam to her strength. Sometimes in competition you can do absolutely nothing to stop somebody from having the swim of their life.
Well, Nicole, she was just 15 when she was fourth in this event in Beijing. Now as a 19-year-old gets the silver medal. So you feel like she'll be in Rio in 4 years' time.
She says she feels like she knows what she's doing now, whereas 4 years ago she was the kid sister of the US swimming team.
Yeah. 16 years of age and on top of the world.
What a fantastic moment.
So not much older than Bysel was 4 years ago in Beijing. So as a 12-year-old, she would have been looking on. Yeah, she won with her home Olympics.
Mm.
Maybe saying to herself, well, I'll be there one day.
Again, it's about a legacy, isn't it? All of the young girls in China looking at Yi thinking, maybe I can do that.
Mm. Well, she'll get another chance here too, I think, in the 200 IM. So gold, silver and bronze, China, USA and China. And all teenagers, 16, 19 and 18. So a 16-year-old defeating a 19-year-old and an 18-year-old. So I think we're seeing a rivalry born here, and you wouldn't be at all surprised to see these three women really having some great battles over the next 4 years at those World Championships and leading into the next Olympics. But it's hard to imagine anyone getting the better of this young woman the way she finished the race off. What was her final time? 4:28.43.
Yeah, the last 100 metres was something like 58 high or 59 low, which is, you know,
irrepressible, isn't
it? Well, it's a boy split in the 400 IM. You know, she was so fast in the last 100. I haven't seen a woman do that. She's broken Stephanie Rice's world record as well in winning the Olympic Games gold medal and also an Olympic record. A lot of the girls do talk about that, about training and racing with the boys in training. Elizabeth Beisel swims with Ryan Lochtin. She talks about trying to race the boys, because if you can be as fast as one of the boys, there's not many girls that are going to keep up with you.
Well, Beisel looks absolutely delighted with the silver, doesn't she?
Well, she had a good swim.
Great swim. Two great swims today.
I think you saying her mouth's hurting already from smiling so much.
Get used to it, I think, if you're going to be that good. And have a look at Beisel.
She's just spotted her family. Did it make its target? Swimmers aren't usually very good at ball sports.
Though Lochte was good earlier tonight. He found his target.
Good. Ah, there you go. And flowers go up. Ah.
The winners are grinners, aren't they, after the women's 400 individual medley. Every great swimming competition needs a world record, and to get one on the first night is perfect.
Sets the ball rolling, doesn't it? I think we'll see many more now.
And that's something that I think 12 months ago wasn't thought possible. No.
But they've started to work on the things that the suits helped them with. They've started to work on core strength a lot more, both in and out of the water, body position, which is something the suits did. They put them in a better body position. So they've started to look at all the things that the suits aided them in and tried to figure out how they could get those benefits through training.
Well, up close and personal, these photographs, aren't they? They're right in the mix. The presentation tonight's been so good, Nicola. I love the way they bring the swimmers out before the finals and the semi-finals.
Something the International Swimming Federation, FINA, has been doing for the past couple of World Championships. Of course, these Olympic Games, the swimming competition is run under the rule of FINA, the Fédération Internationale Natation. So it's nice to see that they're actually bringing some of the things from World Championships into the Olympics. Making their way down to where the interview positions. Once they've won their medals, they go along all of the interview positions, and that the interview positions snake all around the back of the pool and into another corridor. There are hundreds of positions for interviews. Wonder how that walk was for Michael Phelps.
Different.
Yeah. The Australians wait for the gold medal from the 4x100 freestyle. And somebody's playing the right kind of music in the pool. It's suddenly a very famous Australian band in excess.
Well, they're the fastest qualifiers this morning, and it was a great final. It really was. USA challenged so hard through Missy Franklin early. And then
Steve Waugh, a great Australian cricket captain, in the crowd with Australia. He's actually an athlete liaison officer with the Australian team. Isn't she beautiful?
And discovered that there's a big screen in here.
Oh, and I'm on it.
So all those flags, eh? All the nations represented.
204 nations at these Olympic Games.
And swimming growing, isn't it? I mean,
it is.
It was for many, many years a battle between the United States, Australia, and the odd European countries, certainly Great Britain and France at times, etc. But the emergence of so many other countries, and in particular, I think, Asia and South America. South Africa continued to do well. So it's a big world now, the swimming world. And swimmers are going on much longer, aren't they? I mean, once upon a time, two Olympics was just about it, but now
We're
seeing
many line up for four.
Yep, and certainly three becoming common. So the victory ceremony for the 4x100 about to take place. So a great run for the Dutch comes to an end after winning in Beijing, Rome and Shanghai. Going to a team that had a great run of its own just before that. And that's the Australian team who won in Athens and then in 2005 and 2007.
What a moment for all of the girls.
So John Eales there as well, the great rugby player and Australian captain.
He's another of the athlete liaison officers. That's what the Australian team has done these Olympics. They've done it for a while now. Lane Beachley, the world surfing champion, is another of the athlete liaison officers. So Alicia Coutts, they're standing in order of their race. Alicia Coutts, Kate Campbell, Brittany Elmsley and Melanie Schlanger.
One of the all-time great track and field athletes.
What era? Question without notice.
She was in the 60s and 70s.
Okay. It's the time of Betty Cuthbert?
Just after.
Okay.
Around Raylene Boyle's time. Right. So just in the middle of the Cuthbert Boyle in the 60s and then slightly into the 70s. Seven Olympic medals. Americans were good, weren't they?
Oh, they tried.
So Missy Franklin and Jess Hardy, the two that came in.
Franklin wins her first Olympic medal. Jess Hardy, Leah Neal.
Alison Schmidt.
Alison Schmidt. Who's Alison?
He'll be one of the favourites in both the 2 and 400 freestyle.
Yes, there's Leah Neal. Jess Hardy started her career as a breaststroker, was a world record holder in breaststroke and won the 50 and the 100 freestyle at Olympic trials. Regular member of the relay teams for freestyle. That's Jess.
And here's the new girl, eh? The new girl on the block.
Yeah.
The buzz of American swimming, Missy Franklin.
Seven events here.
So one legend giving a medal to somebody who one day might be one herself. That's all in front of her. 17 years of age, just turned. So the USA with the bronze. They've won this event on 14 occasions, the Americans, and isn't that great?
She stayed right to the end. That's fantastic.
The First Lady. So it's the 23rd time this race was held at the Olympics, and they've won 14, the US. They've had some dominating periods, but just a bit frustrating run at the moment. The last time they won the gold medal was in Sydney in 2000.
Medals are impressive, aren't they?
Big.
Very big.
What a great team they are and continue to be. Gold medalists at the last Olympics and at the last two World Championships. Silver medalists here tonight.
You get the feeling, though, with Marlene Vilthoos being around for as long as she has, now being a mum, that perhaps this is the last time we'll see her in Olympic competition.
Commonwealth Jojo was impressive, wasn't she? Really impressive, and she'll be one of the favourites now, if not the outright favourite for the 100 and probably the 50 as well.
Yes, you would definitely think that. There's Marlene. Inga Decker. Her turn of speed in the second 50, Chroma Wajojo, was just amazing. They were considerably behind, eighth after the first leg. And then into second.
And now to the gold medalists.
Well done, girls.
It's a fresh team too, isn't it?
You just got the sense that Brittany Elmsley was almost pinching herself. Taking a deep breath, is this real? There's Mel Schlanger. Trains with Glenn Baker on the Gold Coast. Brittany Elmsley, one of the newcomers on the team, her first Australian senior team. Trains with Matt Brown. There's Kate Campbell. Training with Simon Cusack in Brisbane. And Alicia Coutts, training at the Australian Institute of Sport under John Fowley. She has the 100 butterfly coming up. And she looks impressive. So too Kate Campbell for the 100 freestyle. Kate's family lived for a long time in Malawi. In fact, she was born there and they moved to Australia. It's a big family, and her youngest brother has quite severe disabilities. They moved to Australia for his care, and they're actually all here, including her brother.
And her sister, who swims against her in the 50 freestyle. Well, they have a proud tradition, Australia, in swimming. They've always got a lot of support in any swimming stadium around the world, and that was evident there tonight.
A moment that they'll share for the rest of their lives together, winning an Olympic Games gold medal.
Well, that history is so important. We've seen Dawn Fraser here tonight, the greatest of all Australian female swimmers, and a legend here, still a big part of Australian sporting folklore. So great rivals and good friends at the end of it all. That Australian-American rivalry in swimming is unique. It's the one that has lasted the longest.
Very much so. So a little psychological advantage for the Australians over the Americans. There are three relays for the women and three relays for the men at the Olympic Games. The 4x200 freestyle relay and the 4x100 medley relay are the two that remain.
And the Australians have a pretty good run in the medley for a while, but the Americans are generally, well, certainly the men, but the women too, so hard to beat with the four strokes. Decker looks just a wee bit disappointed. She didn't have the best swim.
No, and when you're swimming as a team, you do feel the responsibility of the other three and the weight of the team. And for her not having a great lead swim for the Netherlands, she probably will feel gutted by that.
So there will be a great response down under. They like their swimming champions, Australia. They like their sport. And these four women will be the centre of all attention through this weekend.
Oh, I feel for Inga Decker. She did withdraw from the 100 butterfly for this. It's still an Olympic silver medal. No, 302 gold, 302 silver, 302 bronze medals on offer at these Olympic Games, and 10,500 athletes here. Not everybody gets to win a medal. So that silver medal is an accomplishment.
And in swimming, those numbers are a lot smaller, aren't they? What have we got, 32,
32.
For men and women?
And then some from the open water as well, marathon.
So
Mel showing her cricket style.
Some good throwing and some good catching tonight. So it's been a great night of swimming and traditional powers to the fore with the United States and Australia and China as well.
Yes.
China really taking the spoils at the end of the night. Three of those young women could be almost sisters the way they look, don't they?
Very tall girls. In fact, Alicia's probably the smallest of them. As to the American team, very tall girls. Particularly Missy Franklin and Alison Schmidt.
It's almost four times as good a relay gold medal, isn't it? Because it's just shared by more, and it means so much to each of the teams.
Sure, their face is starting to hurt from the amount of smiling.
So Schlinger will be back for the 100 free. So Decker, yeah,
She's shattered.
Yeah.
Absolutely shattered. Oh, the poor love.
And Libby Trickett, who swam in the preliminary today, did a great job, and she will actually get a gold medal here to go with her big haul.
And they would be tears of joy. See Jessica Hardy in the 100 freestyle.
So the last rites in terms of the photographs for the medalists. So the Dutch probably have done their bit. And it's the Australians and the Americans. A familiar sight, the kangaroo. Now the Dutch are there. Just some
consolation. Coach has come down.
Gee, it's an interesting response here, isn't it? I mean, they've held it together so well until now, so you can see the disappointment, how much it meant to them.
I mean, training together in the one centre, they've really worked hard to try and defend that Olympic crown. So I think Marlene Veldhu seems to be the one that's trying to hold it together the most. As I said, she is a mum. Sometimes becoming a parent puts everything in perspective, so hopefully she'll be able to just settle the girls down a little bit and help them to understand a silver medal is a fantastic achievement.
So the Australians on a high here. And finishing the first night with the gold in the 4x100 freestyle. Got some fast times tonight. World records were challenged early. We got the one world record. So here's the first of the finals, and maybe the biggest story of them all. Ryan Lochte close to the world record, and Michael Phelps out of the medal. So it was Lochte, Pereira, Hagino in the 400 individual medley. So a changing of the guard, certainly, in men's swimming, and particularly in the United States. A new king of the pool, so to speak. And then the women's semi-finals and the 100 butterfly. Dana Volmer's definitely been the favourite. Alicia Coutts with that gold medal now.
Will be on a high.
Absolutely. And Jeanette Otterson. So they were the finalists there, but it does look Volmer's.
The world record holder's in there as well.
Yeah, Sarah Sjostrom in fourth fastest. But it looks Volmer's not to lose so much, but you feel like she's the winner. Now the 400 freestyle, this was a remarkable race. Remember that Park Tae-won came back in after being disqualified. Sun Yung so close to the world record, 340.14. Park Tae-won, who led it halfway. Peter van der Kuy came through for third. Great race, high quality, a new star born there as well.
All of the races for the medals tonight have been sensational. This was our first world record of London 2012 in the pool.
Yeah, yeah, she won with that 4:28, and that last 200 set it all. Elizabeth Beisel and then Li Jianzhu. And then we came to the breaststroke and the semi-finals there for the men. And a big surprise here. Cameron Vandenberg breaking the Olympic record of 58.83, but the surprise was Kosuke Kitajima. At one stage, not sure whether he would have qualified. He's got through. He's going for a third consecutive gold medal.
He's only got through by 9/100ths of a second.
So much for him to do in that final tomorrow. And then we'll finish with a 4x100 freestyle and the big guns in women's sprinting. Australia, Netherlands, the United States, China to the fore. 1, 2, 3, and then China fourth. Great Britain fifth, gave a great sight actually. Denmark, Japan, and Sweden. A night to remember, set the scene for seven to follow, but hard act to follow, but those that love their swimming know that it just builds and builds and builds, doesn't it? And great rivalries continue and grow, and swimmers add to their tally. But certainly with Lochte and Sun Yung tonight, Yi Shanwan, and the Australian women, they have set a standard to follow. Full stadium tonight, and 17,500. I have seen some great highlights. Not only a beautiful pool, Nicole, but a fast one as well. Perfectly designed by the look of it, both in the water and outside.
Seen some great action. Ryan Lochte winning 400 IM, gold medalist. And what about this man? Sun Yung taking the 400 freestyle. The first gold medal ever to China in the men's swimming.
Great reaction,
great
too.
Great celebration.
20 years of age and the world at his feet. And then followed not long afterwards by an even younger prodigious talent.
16 years of age and winning an Olympic Games gold.
Yeah, she won and took the world record. Stephanie Rice was in that race. Fresh face. And then we came to the relay and it had its twists and turns as you always expect it to.
Some great celebrations from the girls. Australia taking the gold, the Netherlands in second and the USA in third.
And that's the prize at the end of it all. So the first night concludes, a wonderful night of swimming, a world record, China with a couple of gold, and a changing of the guard with Lochte over Phelps. So that's it from the first night of the Aquatic Centre.
Hampden Park in Glasgow.